Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I will actually connect to a VPN service provider and I will show you how to prevent DNS leaks as well by using a VPN, because you do need to establish full tunnels and there are some workarounds there as well, but we will see how to do all of that. Anyway, before I go into all those technical things, I just wanted to say that VPNs are also a cheap solution if you're looking for a static IP address. So if you want to have a home web server or file sharing server or something of a kind with a static IP address, you can have a VPN for, like, they sell them these days for 10 bucks a month, something like that. So that's a very cheap solution for a static IP address, as opposed to going to your ISP provider who's going to sell it to you for a lot larger sum of money, and they will give it to you in a bulk, so you will have to take like 4 or 5, something like that, IP addresses, which you will never get to use. Anyway, those are your budget-friendly solutions for such problems, but we will not be dealing with them today. I just wanted to mention them as a bit of extra information. What we are going to do today is open up this website. I've opened up this one. You can open up any other that you would like, but be sure to check the reviews. And I have opened vpnbook.com primarily because I didn't need to register or anything of a kind. I could just start using a VPN service, no problems, out of the box. I don't need to install any additional software or anything like that. I just need to download a configuration file, and that is fantastic. That works for me really good because there's minimal work needed and it's going to work for you really good as well. However, if you wish to use a different VPN provider, feel free to do so. And in fact, I encourage you to go out on the net and have a look around to see which VPN providers are out there, what people are saying about each one of them, and which are the best, which are in terms of budget and privacy and speed and stability and so on and so forth, because sometimes you get a VPN and the connection tends to break from time to time. That can be a bit inconvenient. Anyway, let's just go ahead and start the connection process. So I don't want PPTP, I want OpenVPN. And which one am I gonna take? Okay, let's take Germany VPN. So this is a certificate bundle. Open with Arc Manager, no problems. Let's extract them to desktop and... Okay, so just extract them there and then I'll create a new folder for them. Just minimize this, there we go. Let's just make it a bit neater. Open VPN, there we go. Let's just copy these things into this folder here. Move it right there. And we have... Remember how we've actually downloaded duplicates of packets with the same name, except one had GNOME in the name of the packet and the other one didn't? So we've downloaded the plugins for GNOME Network Manager and we've downloaded the actual packages for which we can use via terminal as well. So today I'm gonna connect to a VPN using nothing but a terminal, primarily because even you can do it through Network Manager here. It says VPN connections, configure VPN as we've done before, and you just say add and then you can choose here, or you can just import these files here. This is a very simple process and you can do it through a Network Manager, but if you don't, chances are that you will find yourself in an environment that doesn't have a GUI or something like that and you will need to do it via terminal. So process is not very complicated. I will show it to you here. You just have two, three commands that you need to type in and that's it. No more configuration is needed. It's just gonna auto-load, no problems. So let's just go ahead and clear the screen. You see I've been doing some work there. And go ahead and navigate to your desktop. So root, desktop, open VPN. Let's see what's in there. No, I do not want that sort of listing. Give me a long listing. So the ls command also has different forms of listing. I can say la or something of a kind. I've shown this in one of the first tutorials dealing with Linux command line interface. So lsl. And which one shall we choose? We have port 443 going over TCP, TCP port 80, UDP port 25,000, and UDP port 53. I'm going to go ahead with port 443. So type in open VPN space dash dash config space VPN book the which one is it? Yep, TCP 443. Press enter, and it's going to prompt you for a username. Now, don't panic. The username is right on the website. Here, let me just zoom it in for you. See here, you have a username. I'm going to go ahead and copy that. Press enter, and we also need a password. I can't imagine why did they make the password such, primarily because it's a public password for anyone to use. Paste it here, press enter, and the connection is now going, it's being routed. It should be established any moment now. I'm going to go ahead and close this site because I will want to reinitialize my Firefox. There you go, initialization sequence completed. Let's see, where am I? What is my IP? Your IP is 178.162.193.223, and apparently I am in Germany. I can assure you that I am not in Germany. That is definitely the IP of the VPN. But this sort of configuration that we have done now will not withstand the DNS leak test. So we need to actually do some alterations there as well. And in order to do that, we will need a new terminal. So go ahead and open it. Type in nano slash etc resolve.conf. Press enter, and there you go. Now this is generated by Network Manager by default, and the name server is, this is basically your router, home router IP address in LAN. This is not a public IP address, this is one in LAN that you use to access the router from the LAN network. And we don't really want our computer to use our ISP's DNS server. So let's just comment that out. I mean, the way this works is your DNS requests are forwarded here to this name server, which this is basically the IP address of your router, and then your router forwards them to your ISP provider, which in turn records all your traffic and can eventually be used in order to reveal your physical location, which is bad, which is something we want to avoid. So instead of using the DNS server of your ISP provider, what you want to do is go ahead and type in the browser open DNS. I can't do a DNS test like this because I will show you my IP address, but I assure you that this will not pass. This will not withstand it. So where is it? For business personal partners. Yep, there we go. So just go ahead and click on, scroll down and click on DNS. Wait for it to open. It's a bit of a heavy site. Excellent. So in the right corner, in the right side of the page, you can see that you have these IP addresses. I'm trying to zoom it in as much as I can, but it's not allowing me. I'm losing certain aspects of it. Excellent, there we go. So we have 208.67.222.222. So just go ahead and copy that. This is open DNS, which they're as they say, the fastest, safest, smartest DNS services on the planet. So they really are. Many people have confirmed it. They're very nice to use. Other than that, you also have Google's DNS servers, which are 8.8.8 and 8.8.4.4, if I'm not mistaken. Name server space paste, and now I want another one, name server space, and I would like to also have this one as well. Now the reason why you are using two IP addresses and not one is because you want to have a fallback. So if this fails, if for whatever reason this server appears to be down, or if your packets fail to reach it, you don't want your web browser telling you that the connection can't be established or something like that. Rather, instead, you want it just to fall back to this one and then attempt here, and in all likelihood it's going to pass. So one of the two will work pretty much for sure. You can add up to, I'm not actually sure, I think it's three or something like that, but really doesn't matter. Two are more than you need. Just Control O, save it, and exit. Control X to exit. Do not restart your network manager because it will preload the file once again, and you will again be stuck with the DNS servers of your ISP provider. Excellent. So let's just go ahead and see what our DNS leak test says. So DNS, check for DNS leak. What's going on here? We're going to do a standard. You see the IP address is still shown here. It's telling me that I'm from Germany. I'm not. Do a standard test and see what happens here. And there we go. It says host name. You see ISP X. We can conclude from the host name as well. And we have the IP addresses here. But we're not going to look at those now. Just look at the ISP here. It says ISP OpenDNS. 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 Meaning that the ISP provider for my own country has not been revealed here. It has been hidden. If I didn't do this, I would definitely have a DNS leak here, which would be a pretty bad problem, as I would function under the premises that I am anonymous when I'm not, and that can lead to a lot of problems. Anyway, that is how to hide yourselves. That is how to establish a tunnel, something of a kind. I strongly encourage you to do this from the terminal, to establish VPN connections from the terminal. You will have pre-configured files. You can even do the configurations manually if you really feel like it. There's really no need. Takes up a lot of your time. As I said before, you can also do it through the network manager, but I strongly advise against it, primarily because network managers can be different from one system to another. So this is not really a universal way of doing it. Furthermore, there are environments, you will encounter a large amount of environments that won't have a GUI, or you will be in an environment that has GUI, but you will not have the ability to use it. So one problem comes after another if you don't know how to do it in the terminal. Do it via the terminal. That is what I advise you to do. If you really want to do it over the network manager, and if you can't do it on your own, there are a lot of instructions on the net, but if you don't feel like going through them, feel free to post it in the questions section. I will be more than happy to help you out depending on which network manager you are using. In any case, I bid you farewell, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.